Hey there guys, it's your favorite backyard geographer, this time again with a video on the Public Land Survey, otherwise known as Township and Range. You know, did you ever wonder how it was that we were able to map and understand the unforeseen West back in the late 1700s without having handheld GPS, maps, or even Google Images? Well, you're just in luck, because that's what we're going to learn in this video. So, let's get going. So to begin, the Public Land Survey System was the answer to the Land Ordinance Act of 1785. Luckily for us, Thomas Jefferson got involved and he designed a system where settlers could purchase farmland in the undeveloped West. This new rectangular system would allow settlers to identify land without the use of streets or addresses. And in fact, it's still used today. It's actually part of the real estate exam in most states. We often observe this in really, really large areas that just don't have, still to this day, streets and addresses, like parts of the Great Mojave, parts of the Basin and Range area, and even some areas in the Midwest. This was really a unique way for us to create a new system. I don't know if you've had the opportunity of visiting places along the East Coast like New York, where streets are crossing each other and everything seems very angular and just not really well planned. This type of system, this rectangular system, was put forth in order to make sure that streets and roads, as best as they could be, observed in intersecting pieces, where everything would just be square. We often still see some of this in places such as like Palmdale, Lancaster, where you have streets that intersect each other that are either letters or numbers. Well, let's start at the beginning. The first step is to understand just the system. So we have what we consider the baselines and principal meridians. So a baseline, if you can see my mouse kind of floating around, this would be our baseline that kind of divides things very much so as a horizontal piece. Well, this baseline denotes everything north of it or would be south. So it's really kind of like a dividing point. The numbers themselves can go on forever, but that really wasn't quite the system they would use. They would subdivide it in larger territories, but it is not uncommon to see townships up into the teens and 20s. So this is off of our baseline. Then our principal meridian divides everything either east or west of that region. So as an example, where it says 36, where my mouse is, that if I wanted to denote or identify that box, I would say that it is in Township 4 North, in Range 2 East. Now that one box in particular has a value of 36 square miles. That's a really big box. It's 6 miles by 6 miles in area. So think of it more like this. This box here would be like a very small county. Well, if I wanted to have a home or a farm, I would be part of that community. So I need to find a way to subdivide this really large box into something a little bit smaller. And we can actually observe that by subdividing it into smaller sections. So note that I've now observed this little box. It's very hard to see, and I know that, but it does subdivide each of these townships and ranges into 36 smaller pieces, or 1 mile by 1 mile sections. And that's part of step two. So let's observe what a section box would look like. So step two, or the second step, is our sections. It goes 1 through 36, which makes sense because we're taking one of our larger boxes and subdividing it. Now, the numbering is unique. It starts in the top right-hand corner, and I call it the snake method because it zigzags back and forth until it reaches all the way to 36. So we would subdivide maybe that smaller county into a smaller town. So I live in maybe section 9 that is part of that smaller county. Well, again, that's still a nice small piece, but it's still a little too big to be for my home or my farm. So we can actually subdivide this box into what we consider a quadrant. Now, quadrants are something that you've heard of before, because you remember that things are broken up, you know, by looking at a system of north, south, east, west. But what about those corners, like the northeast corner? Well, that's what we consider a quadrant. So these quadrants can be observed like this. Now watch as I add another layer. So we can subdivide these little corners, these corners of, or the quadrants of, each section. Well, let's zoom into one of these so we can see it a little bit better. So these are going to be our quadrants. Now, do note that I'm using two different colors. I'm using a gray and a black in order to kind of explain this idea of quadrants. And that's because we're looking at not just the section box as a quadrant, which is divided into the black boxes, but we're able to even subdivide each one of those quadrants into a smaller piece. So I often think about it as my desk is in the northwest corner of the northwest quadrant of the classroom. So it's that idea of small to large, that part to whole. So that being said, if I had my desk in this spot, or my home was in this box, which, mind you, this larger black box is, again, that 1 square mile, 1 mile by 1 mile, this smaller gray box here would be 40 acres, or a 40-acre parcel of land, that this would be the southwest corner of the northeast corner of the section number, whatever it might be, and so on and so forth. So this is really the part that most people have a hard time with, is understanding the quadrants. But just remember, it's that idea of me living, my desk is probably the best example. My desk is in this corner of the greater classroom. And then it kind of moves forward with that. We always read these small to large. So my desk is in this corner of this classroom, of this building on this campus. Or my house is in this corner of this town, of this city, in this county. And we kind of work our way in that order. Well, let's kind of put this together and see what it would look like. Now, obviously, this is not to scale. It's just for a perspective. Remember, looking at our townships and ranges, each one of these boxes can be subdivided into 36 smaller boxes. I'm just doing this as a very simple diagram, so we're going to be able to relate back and forth, so I don't have to keep drawing it over and over again. And then again, each one of these section numbers can be broken down into quadrants. So again, it's not to scale, but it's just so we can observe this and easily see it. So as an example, let's say, I'm going to use my mouse again, here it is in the screen, I'm interested in this box. Well, this box is the northwest corner of the northwest corner of section number 31, which is part of Township 4 North in Range 3 East. So I know that was a little difficult, but again, we're starting from the idea of small to large. My home, my town, my city, and my county, in essence. Well, let's try with a couple letters. So again, these letters are arbitrary. If you're actually observing it, this would be the most accurate representation of each letter, but just remember, I didn't want to keep redrawing it. So when I'm observing letter J, I ignore these other letters. I'm only focused on the section numbers and that letter, and so on and so forth. So let's start with letter J. So we always start with the quadrants, then we move towards the sections, and then move towards the township and range. Well, J is down here. J is part of the southeast quadrant of the southwest quadrant of section number 35, which is part of Township 2 North and Range 3 East. And that would be the public land survey of that 40-acre parcel of land. Let's try one more. Let's do letter D. Well, remember, we start from the quadrants, move to the sections, and then the township and range. D is in the southwest corner of this quadrant, right? The southwest of the southeast quadrant of the section number, and it goes here to number 30, and it's part of Township 4 North and Range 4 West. I've provided a couple other letters on here for your enjoyment and for your practice. Be sure to try to solve it and go ahead and throw it in the comment box. I hope this was helpful for you. Be sure to like, subscribe, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to comment below, and we'll talk soon.